From Channel 11, this is your McAdam Community Television System.
Quite a crowd. There's about 35 or 40 cars behind us. That,
it's a hard job to estimate, though, isn't it, really?
Yes, it is.
But it is. It seems like a very good crowd.
I'm glad the people are getting, are showing a little bit of concern.
Oh, I believe they have the entrance now.
That's what we need.
Negotiating and as a stand, and I don't mind making it public, from the national union, the local union, we are going to make a definite stand that the mill is there. Nothing is going to move out of the mill after it's shut down. We are going to do everything to stop it, picket it, whatever it is, and if they want to take the raw materials across the border, we are going to boycott the borders until we get a definite answer, one way or the other. Then we'll work from there. But we want a definite answer.
Mr. Bird, what about the question of raw materials crossing the border?
Well, that's certainly a major crux of the whole issue. The present circumstance legally in Canada, constitutionally, is that, I guess I'm thinking interprovincially when I say constitutionally, because there is no way interprovincially that provincial governments have the power to block the free movement of wood. I'm not absolutely certain of the circumstance that pertains to New Brunswick and the state of Maine, except that in this circumstance of the mill at MacAdam, there has been a long-term undertaking that there would be a free flow of wood between the state of Maine and the province of New Brunswick, and that has taken place. Obviously, the facility that was the basis of that undertaking has now closed, and the whole subject is up for re-examination. It has serious overtones beyond MacAdam for New Brunswick in terms of wood flow, because this interprovincial flow that I spoke to you earlier about has a three-pronged equation to it. There is a major flow of wood from the province of New Brunswick to the state of Maine each year, not only to Georgia Pacific, but to Great Northern Paper and to other interests. There is a flow of wood from Maine to Quebec, and there's a major flow from Quebec to New Brunswick, which is all orchestrated and which is all recognized and although not perhaps signed by international agreements, it certainly is recognized and there's a tacit appreciation of it. And New Brunswick is the net beneficiary by about 200,000 cunits a year. So that this situation in MacAdam with respect to wood supply touches on mills in Edmundston and mills in Dalhousie and mills in Bathurst, and that complicates the issue. But it, as I said today, it is unacceptable that a major acreage in New Brunswick's forests, owned albeit privately by a major multinational company, it is unacceptable that those would continue to operate and satisfy mills in the state of Maine while a facility here in MacAdam, which was built on the basis of those forests, is closed.
Sounds to me like you may have some type of action in mind, am I right?
I don't have any action in mind except to try and find a way, hopefully, along with everybody else in the question, to reactivate this mill, to try and identify the factors that have brought about its closure, to see if we can remedy those, working in concert with the company, and to reestablish permanently the employment that has existed here for the last few years.
Mr. Annis, does that satisfy you?
No. It's the statement that you made, Mr. Bird, disturbs me quite a lot when you say there's a net inflow of some 200,000 cunits per year into New Brunswick. And it sounds like all of that goes into the northern part of the province, and it sounds like the outflow comes from the southern part of the province, i.e. this part of the country. And I don't think that's a fair balance. It may be in the overall three provincial state organization that we have working this thing, mm-hmm. but it's the people of Macadam who are being hurt by this thing, and this is what we're interested in.
Well, I think, though, that I did qualify my remarks by saying that it's unacceptable that the facility that was built here in Macadam to rationalize the southwestern New Brunswick participation in that process is now closed. I think that obviously has to be addressed.
Which only brings us to the point where all of the wood from this part of the country goes out of the province now. All of it. At least when the mill was here, some of it was processed.
Well, that's
But
that's
there was
right.
always a net outflow from this particular part
there
of the
certainly
province.
Has always been a net outflow. And prior to this mill being built here, it was far more substantial than it has been since. And I agree with you completely that this mill has been a rationalization of that exchange equation and is an important part of it. And it's unacceptable to continue without it, or without some
offsetting
industrial investment. Whether it's I think we would all have to agree if a plywood mill in Macadam is a non-viable operation, we don't want to perpetuate something that isn't going to work. We've had enough of living on artificial industries throughout North America, really. But surely there is a viable, whether it's a waferboard plant, whether it's a stud mill or what, there's obviously some facility to process these materials from the major acreage of forest that Georgia Pacific owned here. And the principle of that has already been accepted. The establishment of this mill here was an expression of the acceptance of that principle. I think, as I've said several times today, we first got to find out why that facility is no longer viable and see if we can correct that problem.
Yeah. Mr. Osborne, you're a worker at the mill. If the operation is not viable, what effect does that have on you?
Well, I figure maybe it isn't reopened, since there's no other place around here to get a job. So I'd probably have to pull out and look for another job, because I can't support a wife and three kids without working. Unemployment won't help.
Is this a feeling of the rest of the workers at the mill, too?
Well, most people from the mill I was talking to all week are ready to pack it up and move. Most of the young guys now are trying to go down unemployment to see if there's any job out in Calgary so they can have a chance to get unemployment.
Mr. Hull, it's MLA for the area. That must bother you to hear a statement like that.
Certainly it does, and as I say that the Premier, the Minister of Commerce and Development, and the Minister of Natural Resources, and myself are very much involved, and I'm very confident that we'll be able to find an alternative. Certainly it concerns me that people are planning on leaving. I hear this. It isn't the first time that the mill has closed down for a short period of time. We hope that it can be for a short period of time, and we hope that we can turn it around. If we can't, then hopefully they'll be able to find another viable industry for the village of Macadam. And certainly that seeing the support that we had there today from the people, in particular the type of demonstration we had, the caliber of the people that were there, the way that they spoke in defense of keeping the industry going or a similar industry involved, is extremely important. And certainly with the Georgia Pacific owning 350,000 acres of freehold land in this province, and certainly the lumber from that land being processed in the United States is certainly something that we'll have to take a very hard look at. And with the support I have from other members of the cabinet, certainly we're taking a very, very hard look at it, and hopefully that we can turn this thing around.
Mr. Storr, one final question. If this problem is not resolved, will we see more demonstrations in the future or more approaches to government?
Well, naturally, the people in this community are hopeful that this problem can be solved. We're 100% behind what the government's trying to do, but the Chamber of Commerce and the people of the community are not willing to lay down to just let this lie. We definitely are going to take other steps. We're going to do whatever we can to try to promote what the government's trying to do. We're going to do whatever we can to try to keep this industry here because we need it. And there definitely will be a follow-up to it, and we hope that it will come across. the way this one did today, as a supporting type of action for the government and what they're trying to do.
Thank you very much, gentlemen.
Thank you.
You're done.
Thank you.